Hello, I'm Olivier Huens. I'm the head brewer of Brasserie H2O, and I will show you my small brewery. So at first, I'm beginning to brew with this. Yeah, it's not malt, it's wood pellets, because it's the characteristic of this brewery. It's the first brewery in the world who works with wood pellets to eat and make the beer. So I put the wood pellets in this system that I made. It's a pellets burner here, and I put the pellets, wood pellets, in this tank. They are filled in the burner, and after there is a direct fire heating under the kettle. And with this system, it's very nice because I can make beer every time with no problem with gas, petrol, or something like this. And if there is a big problem in the world, some zombie attack, I can continue to brew beer. So after, I will use my grain and put some water in the kettle and mash. After the mash, I transfer it in the loader tun just here. It's an old milk tank, and it's do very light, very good works. And after loadering, I transfer the wort here, and I made the boil. During the boil, I add some hops and some secret spice. After this, I transfer and cool the wort to transfer in this tank. So it's a 50 hectoliters tank, so I put four batch in one tank. It's a Dreflassen technical, and it's horizontal. Horizontal tank, so the, there is no pressure on the beer, and if there is no pressure on the beer, it gives different kind of smell and aroma. And I love to work with this method. It's like the old methods, and it respects more the yeast and the brewing process. After this, I transfer in the other tank. It's my lagering tank, and. After the lagering, I use my small bottling tank. I will show you later. And put the caps, put the label manually, and after go to the hot room, and after we can taste it. And so, voilà.
And out of this, what kind of beers have you produced? Oh, we forgot.
Oh, yeah.
So these are the beers?
Yeah. And actually, I made three different beers. Yeah. The first is was the Ale Capen Winter. It was a beer at 7% of alcohol on the label, but it's a little bit more, I think. And it was a beer with organic malt, and I use sugar to increase the level of alcohol. But it was, I don't remember the name. It was Kensager, and it was an experiment for me to make the same recipe after the Ale Capen without the Kensager. So there is just one difference, it's the level of alcohol. And this experiment was very interesting because there is the same bitterness in the two bottles, but you can taste the difference of the impact of the alcohol about your feeling of the bitterness. So it's an experiment for friends. I brew another beer, the Blockus Triple. It was a triple because a lot of people was very fan of the Winter Capen, and the Blockus Triple was another triple. But with a spice, because I changed a little bit the recipe, and it's a little bit more alcohol too. But I don't have bottle, I'm sold out about it, it's just cake. And the next week I will brew a new recipe, the white spirit. It's a white beer, a traditional Belgian white beer, with a lot of wheat. Some coriander, some orange, and I would like to do it at 4.5% of alcohol because I would like something very drinkable, and you can drink the beautiful sun and
that process the project. Water.
It's a project with two big parts. We are in the end of the first part of the project. It was to prove that it's possible to brew with wood pellets. Now it's done. The next step is to reuse the spent grain to make wood pellets. And so with my spent grain, I make energy. And so it's completely circular system. So actually I'm working on the technology to dry the spent grain and with a system to reuse the heat in the spent grain to dry it. But there, it's an experiment and I don't have it here. It's another place.
And how about the wastewater? What do you do there? The
wastewater.
Chemical.
Yeah, the wastewater. It's something very important in the brewery, and so I decide to use a kettle, and I put all the wastewater in the kettle. So I have a flow meter at the beginning to see, okay, I use good clean water to brew, and I know how many water I put in the tank later. So I can work each time to increase the efficiency of the brewery. Efficiency of the brewery and decrease the wastewater. And so I decided to use a new chemical product too. Normally we clean the tank with caustic soda, but it's very chemical and it's worked very good, but it's chemical. And there is a new technology developed in Belgium that uses enzyme to clean the tank. And so I do some tests with it. And normally for the caustic soda, you need to clean at 80 degrees. And with the enzyme system, it's 55 degrees. So you need less energy. And there's no problem with environment with it because the enzymes are just dead and after it's okay. So.